Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let's take a look at using dictation in Mavericks. So to get started with dictation, first thing you want to do is go to System Preferences. And then you want to go to Dictation and Speech and select Dictation. Now you have several different options. The main one, of course, is whether or not to turn dictation on or off. But just as important to that is whether or not to use Enhanced Dictation. Now, if you don't have that checked off, that means that basically you speak short bursts of text. I think you have about 30 seconds to speak. And then that's sent to Apple servers, probably the same servers that handle Siri. And then that's returned to you as text. So you need a constant internet connection and you can only speak in short bits. And then those are translated and returned to you. And it works fine and it doesn't take up any extra space on your drive. But if you turn this on, you have to do this large download. But once you do that, it's done. And then you have the use of Enhanced Dictation, which is done all locally and it works out much better. Also notice here you can set the microphone and you can set the language. You can add additional languages and then you can change the shortcut key. I'm going to keep it as the default here, which is press the FN key twice. So now let's go into Text Edit and give it a try. I'm just going to try speaking some text after I press the FN key twice. The quick brown fox jumps over the lazy dog. Period. And you can see I hit FN once and it was the same as pressing that done button there. So I can basically hover my finger over the FN key on my keyboard and use it that way. Now notice how it actually did all that. It not only was doing it in real time, but it was kind of adjusting things based on what I said. So as it kind of got the next word, the word after that, it might go back and correct a previous word that made more sense. Now it's not magic. It doesn't do everything quite right. You can see if I just talk normally it's going to get a few things wrong, but it's going to generally do a good job. So where it really shines is if you both type and speak at the same time. Because it's real time you can kind of interact with your words. So let's give this a try. I'm going to try speaking and typing at the same time. Like I added that period there by typing. And I just made those corrections, period. So that makes it ideal for doing messages. Like you can just use it here inside of Mail. You can use this dictation anywhere that the text cursor appears. So I'm going to use the FN key twice here and start dictating a message. To whom it may concern. I received the shipment of penguins, comma, but one of them was damaged, period. Please send a replacement. Period. Thanks. Period. So you may have noticed that I can speak things like comma and period and understand that those are punctuation. There's a whole list of different things that you can say. For instance, open parenthesis, this, close parenthesis. And it figures it out. You can even do some interesting things like some symbols. $50, smiley face. There's an entire list of all the different commands if you go to this page here at the Apple website and you scroll down you'll find a detailed list of commands here and you can see there's all sorts of different things that you can do.